I'm Dr. Joseph Fokam. Actually, I'm the head of the virology laboratory in the HIV Research Center in Cameroon called the Shanta Biya International Reference Center for Research on HIV/AIDS Prevention and Management. And I'm also currently a senior scientist recently in this same center. I'm here for two reasons. The first reason is that my abstract was selected for this forum. I had two abstracts selected. Then the second reason also is that I'm an EDCTP fellow. I'm holder of a career development fellowship, which enabled me also to take part in the first day of the meeting with the various alumni of EDCTP. Actually, I have two major impacts with my career development fellowship. The first impact is a scientific impact, because I'm trying to look at HIV among adolescents, treatment response of adolescents, drug resistance, and the virus variability, with the aim of helping every adolescent to have a good treatment response so that they can easily transition to adult care without having any major clinical problem. So we hope to develop a model that could be used across sub-Saharan Africa for a better management of adolescents who were born with HIV infection. So that's my major scientific impact that I'm expecting. And in this forum already, I presented our preliminary data from what we already have as a baseline information. Now, in terms of research governance impact, I expect from this fellowship to also have a kind of growth in my career leadership. And for example, what I already have is amazing as impact. Immediately I got accepted for this career development fellowship, I had two major impact in my personal life. One, I moved from associate to a senior scientist position, thanks to this grant. And then secondly, I was appointed head of a laboratory. So moving from a member of a lab to a head of a laboratory. So I'm really thankful to EDCTP for giving me this chance that is quite able to enable scientific growth and at the same time career leadership. And I'm expecting that at the end of my career development fellowship, I may be able to move towards a position of an associate director of science. Why not? So I was highly impressed by talks from previous success stories of scientists that have been awarded EDCTP grant. From them, I realized most of these scientists have become senior scientists, professors, and today they are even in big scientific board meetings. And they really have a major impact in Africa. So I was able to see how from a small grant, a medium, to a senior fellowship grant, they are now active leaders. They are now contributing on a daily basis in alleviating the burden of disease in Africa. That was globally, and I have the feeling that tomorrow also I may be able to achieve a similar goal. Then secondly, I also had the opportunity from all those senior fellows who were presenting to interact with them, to discuss with them, and to share what I have like challenges in implementing or in managing my grant. And amazingly, I received so many advice, I received so many tips, and actually I'm going back home fulfilled because I'm pretty sure I will be able to alleviate all the little challenges that I have. And I'm confident that my grant will effectively go through without having any major setbacks anymore. So for me, what I think we could be added in this alumni meeting is to make sure the four network of excellence that we have should enroll active fellows within their network so that they could better interact, and at the regional level we will be able to see a greater impact from what EDCP is doing, since currently we have some fellows with their grants who are not fully part of the regional network. So we believe getting them together, all the active grant fellows with the regional network of excellence, we will be able to have a greater outcome at the end of our various projects. Because I have realized that within this network of excellence, they have a lot of experience, they have clinical trials facility, for which some of the fellows are not aware of or may not have access at the moment. So I think in the long run, this is something that we can better harness in order to have a greater outcome, which is already a success story at the moment. I was also in Lusaka, the last forum in Lusaka, in Zambia, you remember, in 2016, where I had my first exposure to EDCDP Forum, and then I had a chance to interact with very big scientists and to listen to big scientific talks. I would say the major difference I had with this forum actually is the capacity of EDCDP to put together scientists and the industry. I find this very interesting. And we have realized now, thanks to EDCDP Forum, there is a platform where scientists can directly collaborate with the industry in order for each party to understand the need of each other. And actually also we are just out from this big meeting, and we now understand also that EDCDP is showing some interest in what the industry is also placing. For example, now there are calls that are going towards interaction between infectious diseases and non-communicable diseases, for example, cancer. So I find this very interesting, and EDCDP Forum actually serves as a good platform for scientists to meet with the industries in order to address the real need of the local community. So for me, this is a major outcome that I have achieved also during this meeting, and it will help me to better shape future research questions as well.